Hey everyone, welcome back to another product tutorial for MotionVFX.com. Today we're talking about the brand new plugin mGrid, and I have some help showing this plugin off today. Oh, he's calling in. Pops, can you hear me?
Hello?
Hey Pops, look down at the screen. It's not a telephone. You don't have to put it on your ear.
Oh, there you are, George. Hey, listen, I don't like this. I don't like the grid. What happened to talking to people face to face?
Pops, this is just another way to talk to each other. You can still talk to people face to face.
Meh.
Hold on, we're getting another call.
Hey Pops, hey George. Hey listen, why don't you tell me a little bit more about this new plugin?
Yeah, tell us more! Alright, so this new plugin allows you to do exactly what you see here. Create grids, animations for calls, etc. at a higher level of quality over a screen recording, say an actual conference call. Now, let me show you how this all works.
George! Who are you talking to?
The incredible people that support MotionVFX, of course.
So quit yapping then. Jeez, you're just like your mother. Teach the people how to do it.
Let's get started. Once you have installed mGrid via mInstaller, you can locate mGrid in your effects and your titles. mGrid comes with 37 different pre-animated and customizable grid options as effects that you lay on your clips. You have multiple vertical options for vertical aspect ratios, square options for square aspect ratios, and horizontal for horizontal aspect ratios. You also have a few options for customization, as well as an avatar for your clip. Moving over to the title section, these are working as adjustment layers. You have three different backgrounds where you can blur your background, add a custom solid that can be used together with your icons, and a grid. You have seven pre-animated popular styled icons, and four options for typography. So why don't we go over what we did here for our introduction. As you can see here, we have the join, chat, and schedule icons. Now, you can see that each of these have their own on-screen controls, and you have many options in your published parameters, such as position, rotation, scale, background, and background fill and colors, and if you'd like, an icon shadow. We can quickly change any of these colors by selecting our color swatch and making that adjustment. On this clip, we do not have any effects. Let's push down and we can see that we have our incoming call. So we used several here. First, we have our color solid, which includes our on-screen controls so that we can place this wherever we'd like quickly and easily. And of course, we have all of our published parameters in our inspector if we would like to make changes to the color, opacity, and if you don't want to use those on-screen controls, you can make those changes in your inspector. Above that, we have our dismiss icon, which again comes with on-screen controls and published parameters. Our incoming call, which we actually use typography number 4, as you can see here, but we made changes to that text. In our title text, we typed in incoming call, and our subtitle text, we know that Pops is calling. And we have our call icon, of course, with our on-screen controls and again, published parameters. Now I'm gonna zoom in here by pressing Command Plus, and you can see that we have overlaid another call option here with that pre-animation as I am essentially tapping to accept our call there. So it is just another call option laid on top. and we give the illusion that I am tapping that button. Now you'll notice that our clips are now split, and I did use compound clips. The only reason I did that was because I did a little bit of retiming of some of the clip so that we know that my dialogue was going to fit. So you do not have to use compound clips. I would suggest if you are working with vertical video and you're in a horizontal project, you can make a compound clip on your vertical video so that it will line up properly in your horizontal project. We did not do that. We just made compound clips so that we could use those for retiming. So with that said, as we push down, you can see on our first clip, we have used in the mGrid effects, the horizontal 2:1 16:9 project effect. And what that's doing is that's placing us on a 2:1 grid. So you can see there's a pre-animation. We have the same effect applied to the pops clip. So these are exactly the same. Now what you will notice is we have an on-screen control. This on-screen control is only going to do one thing, and that is place your clip on the grid. So it is snapping in place. As you can see, because we are 2:1, they are side by side. As we make that change, it is only going to snap once we pass that threshold. And you can use your on-screen control to scale your footage. So as you can see, we also have some different titles going on here. So as we push in, we have our Pops Typography 1. It's just giving some context as to who it is on the screen, which is very popular in different applications used for conference calls. And we have Typography number 1 as well over here to the left side. Now, these do come with on-screen controls. Let me show you here. You can see that that was just off camera, but we do have on-screen controls here as well that make working really, really quickly with our clips. You can also see that we have a few new icons, which is our active icon. And again, on-screen controls and color options. Something that's really fun about this though, as we move down, is you'll see we have our mute on and off. If we want to have the appearance of an individual being muted, then we can just toggle that on and off. All right, let's zoom back out and continue moving down our timeline. And now you can see we have our color solid coming in to give us the background. We have our join icon and typography number 4 that we are using for our group call, which we have just selected in the text, group call and plus 2 people. So we're about to add 2 people. Now, what happens here is, again, our clips have been separated and we've got the animation out on each of our 2:1 grids toggled. As you can see here, animation out. And then we move into a new type of grid, which is our horizontal 2:2. And because we have the animation in on each of these, they are going to animate beautifully together. And again, it is the same principle, but now we have the option to snap our grid down or to the right. So you can see that that is only snapping, so super quick. So if I wanted George over here on the right, and I wanted Pops over here on the left, there we go. It was as simple as that. Very, very quick changes. I'm going to press Command Z to undo those changes. And you can see we have our typography 1 selected for each of these George Edmondson's different versions of myself here. And we have the active buttons to signify that many of us are speaking. Now, you can see that Pops, currently, we have toggled the mute button. So as you can see here, we have toggled Pops off, so he is not allowed to speak at the moment. And as we push down, we have changed our bottom Georges here. You can see that they are currently toggled to speak mute on. And as we push down, we are now showing that we have that muted. So it's a lot of fun to just play with these different icons and grids. You can put something together very, very quickly, very efficiently, and you don't have to sacrifice quality when you're creating a grid style video. So I'm going to use some different screenshots to just show you how quickly we can make this grid. I'm going to grab a screenshot and bring each of these in just on top of each other. Now, the aspect ratio of these screenshots are all a little bit different. And so what we are going to do is set all of these to spatial conform fill. And now you can see that each one is filling our screen. I'm going to click and drag and select each of these clips and double click our horizontal two so that we can create that 4x4 grid. Now it's as simple as using our on-screen controls to just click and drag into each section of our grid to snap that in very, very quickly. And you can see they are animated to move together and animated to move out. So very, very fast. Let's open our title browser again. Now, why don't we bring our color solid in on top? We can make this just a bit smaller using our on-screen controls. And why don't we bring in our schedule icon, our chat icon, and how about our share screen icon? Now, using our on-screen controls, I can just quickly scale that down, or I can come over and type in a value, such as 55%. Move that over on the x-axis. Let's do the same with our chat. So we can double click, type in a value, and with our schedule, why don't we just use our on-screen controls here, bring that down just a bit. I think that I want to actually move this over and make this much closer to the center, and we can use our color solid tools to just bring that in closer. And if we wanted to add a bit of typography, we can click and drag typography number 2 and use our on-screen controls to bring that information down and scale down just a bit. And there you have it, quickly created a 4x4 grid with some animations, animated typography that are all animated beautifully together in a matter of seconds. Thank you for checking out this tutorial on the brand new plugin mGrid, now available from MotionVFX.com. Be sure to subscribe and we'll see you on the next one.